गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स. सो टुडे आफ्टर फ्यू गैप वी हैव ऑलरेडी अगेन स्टार्टिंग द वीडियो क्लासेस. सो स्टूडेंट्स, आई हैव ऑलरेडी गिवन सम प्रॉब्लम्स एंड वी विल सॉल्व दैट प्रॉब्लम्स ओनली थ्रू दिस. ओके, सो लेट्स सी द क्वेश्चन नंबर 20. I am reading the question, so please go through it. A company manager is considering three projects. Which are mutually independent, and any of them can independently be selected. Independently, they have to select. Three projects are there. The company has necessary fund but cannot take more than one project. Company has sufficient fund but he can accept only one project. The overall cost of the capital is 10% and expected cash flow is also given for the that is project, as you have to mention in the thing. So but listen here, problem number 20. So the company has three projects, that is project and investment and year one, year 2, year 3, year 4, then year 5. Project A, this B, this C. Investment is initial, that is 10,000, then it is project B is 14,000 and project C is 9,000. Year 1 it is 12,000, nothing, no. Then it is 3,000, then it is 4,000, then this one it is 10,000. Here it is 5,000. Then year 4, 5,000. And here it is 5,000. Then it fifth, 7,000. And it is 20,000, 2,000. And the total overall cost of the project is 10%. So students, here it is given by the management of three project, and that is the investment as well as also expected cash flows from the project. And consecutively it is given for the 5 year. Okay, year 1, year 2, year 3, year 4 and year 5. Okay, these are the years, subsequent years are given. Okay, and this is the regular expected cash flows from the that is the project, various project, three project itself. And you are required to advise the management, because management is already that is inform you that is whatever may be the capital that is sufficient capital he has, the company has, it has, but you have to decide that is which project it will be the accepted by the management. That is a what happened financial management. You have to predict, that is, which will be the profitable, what project for the management. And out of the three project, that is, company is going to choose, that is, only one project. So, my dear students, so this is the question. Okay. So, here we have to calculate it. That is the profitable, that is profitable index method mein hum account karenge. So, let us study about what happened. Here it is, what happened? The year. Okay. First, you have to derive the calculation of the present value. Okay. That is, you have to calculate the present value. So, calculation of present value of the cash flow. Okay. So, here it is here given the cash flow, the rupees, then it is the present value factor at the rate of 10%, that is rupees, then here it is the present value. So, my dear students, for each project you have to calculate it. Okay, that is the project A. Project A, then the project B, then the project 3, project C. So year wise, let us first year. In the first year, it is what happened? That is 12,000. Project A 4, it is 12,000. So put it here, 12,000. Then project, that is another, in the second year it is 3,000. In the second year it is 3,000. Okay, for C, for next two project there is not at all. No, in the first year there is no cash flow is there. Okay. So this is what happened. At the rate of factor 10 means what happened, we know, that is 0.909. And here it is 0.826. So you multiply this one, we will get, that is 10,908, and another, that is 2,478. Then totaling, we will get what happened, 13,000, that is 386. Then in the project, that is 2, what happened? See here, that is again 3, 4, 5. Project field mein 3, 4, 5. So the 3, then it is 4, 5. 10,000, 5,000, 7,000. 10,000, then it is 5,000. 7,000. So here it is what happened, 0.751, then 0.683, then 0.621. Then you again multiply it here, that is 7,510, 3,415, then 4,347. Then you again total it, that is 15,272. So in the project, again see, project is 4,000, 5,000, then second year may 4,000, third year may 5,000, fourth year may 5,000, and fifth year may 2,000. So I did again put it 2, 3, then 4, So here it is 4000, then it is 5000, so here it is 0.826, then 0.751, then 0.683, then 0.621. Again, you multiply this one, you will get what? That is 3304, then 3755, then 3415, then 1242. So now it is what happened? We will get 11,000, that is 716. So this is the what happened in the project A, total cash inflow that is within 2 years, that is 13,886. In project B, it is about 3 year, third year, fourth year, fifth year, you will get that is 15,272. And second, in the project C, second year, third year, fourth year, fifth year, you will get 11,716. My dear students, you have to calculate the profitable index of all the three project. So in the case of what is the profitable index? So see, profitable index is equal to present value of cash inflow by the present value of cash outflow. So in project A, it is the PI is equal to 13,386 by 10,000. So this is, you will get what? 1.339. And in the case of the project B, that is PI is equal to, here what happened, that is how much? 15,272 by, that is what happened, 14,000. It is total outflow is 14,000. You will get what happened, 1.091. And in the case of that is project, that is C, that is PI, it is what happened, that is 11,716 by, you will get 9,000. So that is equal to 1.302. So now you can, student, you can compare that is which project is the better. So here one project A is 1.339 and project B is profitable index is 1.091 and in project C the profitable index is 1.302. Here, so better for suggestion what? That is profitability index of project A is the highest. The management is advised to take project A. Okay, student, this is the what happened, that is regarding the question number 2, 20, what I have written, that is the question number 20, it is given, that is what happened, 3 project is given, okay, that is the project A, project B, project C, and according to that is the what happened, the cash outflow is what happened, 10,000, 14,000 and 9,000. And year wise, that is the cash inflow here. Okay, first of all, we have to find the present value of the cash flows. Okay, and regarding this is what happened, the project A, project B and project C, we have identified separately. Okay, thereafter what happened, we have to find the profitable index of all the project, given project. Okay, so from this profitability index we conclude that what happened, that is project A is getting the highest profitability index. So better we can suggest to the management to choose the project A. Okay, this is the about things. And another question number 21. So dear students, another problem here for 21. We have to rank the projects in order to the order of the desirability according to the payback period method and the net present value method or the index method, that is the discount rate is given 10%. Here it is a 100, that is project A, B, C, D, E, F, G. Initial outlays 10,000, that is 8,000, 4,000, then 10,000, then 5,000, then 6,000, then it is 2,000. Annual cash. Annual cash flow, here it is 2,500, 2,600, then 1,000, then 2,400, then 1,125, then 2,400, then 1,000, then life in years. Life in years, it is 5 years, 7 years, 15, 20, 15, 6 and 2. And that is we have to calculate the, this is the given only what happened, we have to orderly find it, that is you have to rank the project. Okay, in this case what happened, it is given that is the initial outlay of the project A is 10,000 and annual cash flow is 2,500. It will take what happened, life of project is what happened, 5 years. And here in project B it is the initial outlay is 8,000 and the annual cash flow is 2,600 and a life of life of the project is whatever term of the project is 7 years. And C, that is 4,000, 1,000 and 15, and year D, 10,000, 2,420, and E, project E may 5,000, 1,125, 15, and 6, that is in the case of the F, that is 6,000 initial outlay and 2,400 the cash flow, and it is the life is 6 and in the G 2000 and 10,000 as well, also that is the 2 year it is given. So we have to find or to rank it. So here in this category, what you have to find it, that is first ranking. Ranking of the project, ranking of the project according to payback period method. Payback period. Okay. Here it is the project. Then initial outlay, then annual cash flow, annual cash flows, then payback period. Yes, then it is the rank. So the project is given A, B, C, D, E, F and G. Initial outlay is 10,000. Then 8,000, 4,000, again 10,000, then 5,000, then 6,000, then it is 2,000. Annual cash flow, it is what happened? 2,500, 2,600, it is 10,000 or 1,000. 2,400, 1,125, then 2,400, then 1,000. Now it is the case of the project payback period. Payback period means what happened? The payback period formula is initial outlay by the annual cash flows. What happened? That is 10,000 by 2,500. That it is equal to 4.0. Then here 8,000 by 2,600, here it is 3.1. Then 4,000 by 1,000, then here you get 4.0. Then again 10,000 by 2,400, then you will get 4.2. Then it is 5,000, then 1,125, here you will get 4.4. So again 6,000 by 2,400, that is 2.5. Then 2,000 by 1,000, that is 2. Now friends, so this is the what happened. The different project is there, A, B, C, D, E, F, G, and initial outlay is what happened, 10,000, 8,000, 4,000, 10,000, 5,000, 6,000, 2,000 of the various projects, and the cash, annual cash inflow is 2,500, 2,600, 1,000, 2,400, 1,125, 2,400 and 1,000, and you have to find the payback period, that is the year wise. In the first project, you have been in the 4 years. And second, it is 3.1 year, and at C 4.4 years, and in the D it is 4.2 years, E it is 4.4 years, F it is 2.5, and G it is 2.0. So first of all, what happened? Which is the lowest? Come period mein, comes samay mein, kaun sa project jada दैट इज रिकवर हो सकता है, ये है फर्स्ट, ओके, देन इट इज द सेकेंड, ओके, सी दिस वन एंड थर्ड, दैट इज दिस वन द थर्ड, ओके, देन फोर्थ दिस वन, ओके, देन फिफ्थ दिस वन, यू गिव इट द फोर्थ एंड फोर्थ, ओके, द फोर्थ एंड दिस इज ऑल्सो द फोर्थ एंड दिस इज द फिफ्थ एंड दिस इज द सिक्स्थ. सो दिस इज द रैंकिंग, दैट इज व्हाट हैपेंड, वी हैव गिवन, दैट इज अकॉर्डिंग टू दैट व्हाट, दैट इज द पेबैक पीरियड मेथड. देन यू हैव टू फाइंड, दैट इज द हाउ द प्रोजेक्ट, दैट इज यू हैव टू कैलकुलेट द नेट प्रेजेंट वैल्यू, प्रेजेंट वैल्यू, और दैट यू कैन कैलकुलेट द प्रॉफिटेबिलिटी इंडेक्स. सो माय स्टूडेंट्स, नाउ हियर द सेकंड कैटेगरी यू हैव टू डू इट. सो रैंकिंग प्रोजेक्ट्स अकॉर्डिंग टू नेट प्रेजेंट वैल्यू इंडेक्स, ओके. सो हियर प्रोजेक्ट्स देन इनिशियल आउटले, then annual cash flow, annual cash flow, then present value factor, okay, at the rate of 10%, then present value. So this is a B, C, D, E, F, G. Okay. So initial 10,000, then 8,000, 4,000, then 10,000, then 5,000, then 6,000. Then 2,000. Cash annual inflow it is 2,500, 2,600. Then it is 1,000. Then 2,400, 1,125. Then 2,400. Then 1,000. Factor me. That is. Here it is as per the annuity table. Annuity table mein 3.791 लिसन, हियर यू प्रोजेक्ट एंड लाइफ, यहां पे लिख दो लाइफ ऑफ द लाइफ, मतलब ये 5, ये 7, ये 15, ये 20, देन ये 15, देन ये 6, देन 5 इयर्स में 3791, 7 में इट इज 4.868, then here it is 7 point, and this figure you will get the at the last of the book, okay. Already I have sent you in the one sheet, okay. 7606 here it is given, then 8000, that is 514, then again 7000, that is 606, okay, then 4 point, that is 355, then 1.736. So you will now multiply this one, okay, you will get 9478, okay, then 12,000, that is 656 57, and 7,606, then 20,434, then 8,000, that is 557, then again 10,452, then 1,736. Now, student, this is the figure, that is what happened, ranking of the project according to the net present value method. Then after that we can find it, what happened. So now, that is the profitability index, PI is equal to present value of cash inflow by, that is the initial outlay, A, that is 9,478 divided by 10,000, then this is, you will get 0.9478, or that is, you can 0.95. Then B, that is 12,700, 6,057 divided by 8,000, okay, then you will get 1.58. C, you will get 7,607, 10,606 by 4,000, then you will get 1.90. And D, that is what happened, 20,434 divided by what happened, 10,000. So that is, we will get, that is what happened, 2.04. Then E, that is 8,557 divided by 5,000. So this is 1.71. F, we will get what happened, that is 10,452 divided by 6,000. So you will get 1.74. G, 1,736 divided by 2,000, that in will get 0.87. So dear students, according to the, that is what happened, A and G, what happened, have the net present value less than 1, so it should be rejected. And project D, this is the highest net present value method, 2.04, and that is, it is ranked 1, and project C, it is ranked 2, okay, project C is 1.90, it is ranked 2, okay, this is the first rank, okay, then second rank, then third rank, fourth rank, and this is the fifth rank, and these two will be what happened, it will be what, rejected. So this is the what happened, that is two problems, that is mostly on the basis of the capital budgeting. That is one problem it is given, that is how to rank, and last problem, so we have to find it also, same thing. So another two problem will be discussed in the next class. Thank you. Have a nice day. Stay safe. Thank you.